to Paul's Kitchen, another exciting version of Who Knew What You Could Do with Italian Salad Dressing. Today, we're going to do steak and eggs and home fries. So, I'm using the sirloin strips. We're going to marinate it. Technically, we're going to season it, just a little bit of marinade dressing. At the same time, I'm going to be making the home fries. Right after that, or should I say first, we're going to make homemade banana bread. So, you're going to need very ripe bananas, as you can see, four of them. We'll need a loaf pan, parchment paper, two large eggs. I use the cooking spray coconut oil. You can use whatever kind you want. Some salt, a stick of butter, melted. We're going to use vanilla extract, a little bit of baking soda, sugar, flour, and we're going to add chocolate chips to our banana bread. Okay, so there it is, our sugar and our butter, all melted. We're gonna add two eggs, two large eggs. It goes right in. I think I forgot to mention the milk earlier, but hey, we're gonna show you. A quarter cup of milk. Okay. It's in. Teaspoon of vanilla extract. Okay, so I've switched over to a whisk. We got our ingredients in there. Right, mix it up nice. It's all blended. Now I'm gonna put four very ripe bananas. We're gonna mash them in there. And I mean, very ripe, as you can see. Basically, that's how you want them. So we'll put these in, four of them, and mash them up, and guess what? I'll see you in a few minutes. Okay, we got the four bananas in here. I'm gonna mash them all up, blend it. Then we're gonna add the flour, we're gonna add the baking soda, and the salt. Okay, now let's play with it. Make sure you have four very, very ripe. I mean, let them sit, let them get black, like you saw that. It just makes a huge difference when you're baking. Okay, here's the four bananas blended in. See how I did that? You can already smell it. So those are the four. Now we're gonna add 2 cups of flour. So we got a teaspoon of baking soda. I'm gonna pour it in from the baking container. I'll see you in a second. Okay, quarter teaspoon of salt. Mix it all up. Okay. Oops, I'm making a mess. It's okay, it's homemade, it's supposed to be a little messy. All right, now, the last part is we're gonna fold in the chocolate chips, and we're gonna use a half a cup of chocolate chips, or morsels, whatever you wanna call them. So, where's that little one? Here it is. Here's a half a cup. Now I'm going to take the chocolate chips, put a handful in, and fold it. Alright, we're going in the oven. It's 5 of 9 in the morning. Yes, I'm doing breakfast for steak and eggs. That's next. But the banana bread's going in now. So about 10 o'clock, we'll take it out. And I'll show you what it looks like. Say bye-bye, banana bread. Eat you later. Okay, so I rinsed my steak off, and now I'm drying it. Because you don't want it wet. We're going to start marinating. Well, not really marinating. I'm just putting a little Italian salad dressing in the seasoning. Usually I put a little oil, but the dressing gives it a little bit more flavor and it actually helps the seasoning stick to the steak. So, there, all kind of dry. Here's our Italian. Shake, shake, shake. Shake, shake, shake. Shake your bottle. All right, well, this is how much Italian dressing we're gonna use. One. Two, three. Put it right in. Look at the size of these. Oh, now that's breakfast. See ya. Okay, so we put the Italian salad dressing all over the steaks. Now we're gonna season it up. We got garlic powder. Garlic is our friend. Sazon, the Goya, the orange, awesome. All right. This Goya, adobo. The yellow bottle, rosemary, Some Italian seasoning. Montreal steak seasoning. Good old salt. And pepper. Okay, that's one side. Now we'll do the same to the other side. Those are ready for the grill. Let's start on our home fries. So I washed my potatoes, I patted them dry with some paper towels. Now for the home fries, cut it in half. Cut it in half. And cut, cut, cut. And there's our home fries. Okay, potatoes, our home fries. Right here, all cooked up. I used four, there's only two of us. I eat a lot of potatoes. Oil. See how much I'm using? That should be enough, right there. Now I'm gonna get it nice and hot on the burner here I have on. Next is butter. It's about 3 to 4 tablespoons, I'd say 3 tablespoons. I have more butter, don't worry about it. Let me get some. All right, there it is. Butter's in there. I'm gonna put these right in. Alright. Start with the Goya, the Sazon. Our garlic powder. A little Italian seasoning. Salt. Black pepper. Toss it. You can use a spoon. But if you want to learn how to toss it, it's pull it here, lift, flip, lift, flip, and then you get used to it after a little while. All right, we're gonna let these cook. It's gonna take about 10 minutes on here, because they're kind of big, but about 10 minutes, when the 10 minutes is up, I'm gonna hit it with Italian salad dressing, let it cook a few more minutes, then we're gonna throw it in the oven, then we're gonna go outside, and we're gonna do the grill. Grilling, chilling and grilling. So I had it on high heat. I turned it down to medium high. We're gonna let them cook. This is how they look. You see that? They're cooking. Okay, too bad you can't smell it. I wish you had the smeller. During it, I like to add a little bit more butter. More flavor, see? About half a tablespoon. There. So I'll let this cook out. Still got a little ways to go. I said about 10 minutes, only been a few. All right. To the banana bread mixture. You know, this is the best part. There's a little bit left over. Oh my God, it's so good.
That's my favorite part.
Okay, I just wanted to show you me munching like a fool. Okay, so it's been about 8 minutes. They're cooking. We're gonna hit the Italian salad dressing. Hear that? That's what you want. All right, let that cook out about 2-3 minutes. We're gonna put it in this pan. I'm gonna stick them in the oven. I just started my grill. We'll go out there, we're gonna start grilling, chilling, and making those yummy steaks. We've been going for about 15 minutes now. You see our home fries? Look at those. Okay, now I'm gonna put them in here. I'm using the spoon with the holes, they call them female spoons. Because I don't want as much grease in here. I want to get them a little crispy in there. I'm going to put a little bit of grease, but not a lot. So we'll shut this off. About 15 minutes in there. I left it for about another 4 minutes after I put the Italian salad dressing in. All right, let that dressing cook in. Get all that flavor. So I'll put these in. Put them down all over here. Let them cook while they're still, you know, let them keep cooking. Right. My grill's getting nice and hot. We got it covered. I'm gonna get it up to about 600 degrees. Give it a quick brush from last night's grilling and chilling. Then we're gonna cook those sirloin strips probably about 14 minutes because they're pretty thick. All right. So we're gonna stick these in the oven for as long as we need to. Probably about 14 minutes. Maybe another 15 minutes. We're still gonna do our eggs, but let's get the steak going. All right, guys, at the grill. This one here I've got on high, these two. These I have a little bit lower. So I'm gonna get the nice char on these right here. And as we cook them on later on, I'm gonna put them over here on the lower heat just to cook the insides a little bit better. Here we go. Ah, love that sound. Okay, so I cracked half a dozen eggs because I like eggs. We're gonna eat some scrambled eggs. We're gonna just whisk them, add some milk. 6 eggs, this is how much I use. Okay, we just whisk them up. We're gonna add garlic powder, salt, and pepper. Okay, so our eggs are seasoned, ready to go. We'll go back and check on those steaks. You wanna come with me? Come on. Again, I wish you could smell them, but if you do them at home, you will. There we go. Flame broiled. So this one's kind of fat. I'm gonna put it over to the low section. Just a little bit lower. Cook it low and slow, finish those. These are a little bit thinner. That one was pretty good. We'll leave these for a few more minutes and then we'll switch them over to the almost completely done side. Ready? Okay, so our scrambled eggs. I put just a drop of oil, see it? Just a drop. Butter. Home fries is still cooking in there. Steak's still going. Just about done. They were really thick, so I left them on a little bit longer. And I put them over to the low side. Remember I was telling you the other side? So just the inside's cooked. We're gonna go get those in a minute. Let's start our scrambled eggs. Let the butter melt, or the butter melt, whichever one you want to do. All right. So our breakfast and our little snack, the banana bread, are almost done. Well, the breakfast is, then we're gonna eat it. Yummy. Okay, so I took the thinner strips off. Beautiful, medium rare. About 14 minutes on these. Those fat ones, I'm gonna leave them in there for 2 or 3 more minutes on the little low side, remember? Oh my God. Awful, absolutely awful. You gotta let them sit for about 5 minutes before you cut them, let them rest so all the juices don't go flowing. I salt them when I take them off. Do whatever you want. All right, steak, the other tip's almost done. Home fries are just about done. In about 15 minutes, we're gonna be checking that banana bread. Okay, so those other ones are just about done, and I'm gonna give you a bite.
Yummy. Good.
So the home fries, they're in there for about 18 minutes longer. I put these fatter ones in there for about 18 minutes, because you see how big they are compared to the other ones. So these are going right in here.
About one steak.
We salt them. Home fries. The eggs only took about a few minutes. I got them a little bit dark because I was out there on the grill, but they're yummy. So, I should put these in a bowl and look better, but hey, who cares? Alright, let me put it together. I'll show you the finished product. And here's our finished product. Steak and eggs and home fries. That's a yummy breakfast no matter when you do it, especially on the weekends because you can just sit back and relax. And our banana bread is still in there. We still got 10 minutes. We're gonna check it out and you're gonna see how the tops look. Just incredible. Now, I'm gonna mow like I'm, you know what. See ya. Let's call it in the crossfire. Let's call it in the crossfire.